Module 3, Configure Permissions. Hello, I'm Peter Myers, the course developer.
And I'm Noam, a product manager on the Power BI embedded team.
In this video, we'll describe token types and how to acquire an access token.
Access is granted using two different types of tokens. There's the Azure AD token, and there's also an embed token. Let me now describe each token type. The Azure Active Directory token, also known as an Azure AD token, must be acquired to access Power BI content. The Azure AD token will be acquired differently depending on your embedding scenario. If you're embedding for your organization, it will be acquired from an app user. If you're embedding for your customers, it will be acquired using a dedicated Azure identity. The Azure AD token contains claims to identify granted permissions to the Power BI REST API and to control which content will be presented. A valid Azure AD token must be present in all API operations. Consider this as your key for embedding.
The second type of token is the embed token, and it's a very different concept. An embed token must be acquired to embed Power BI content and query data when using the For Your Customers scenario. It is generated by using the REST API. It contains claims to access specific Power BI content and other facts.
All Power BI REST API calls require a valid Azure AD token. Keep in mind that by default, this expires after an hour. The authentication flow will differ based on the scenario, whether you're embedding for your organization or for your customers.
Here are some important facts you need to know when developing for the For Your Organization scenario. App users have Power BI accounts and appropriate licenses. The app user's account is used to authenticate with Power BI. The app user's identity is used to access content and query datasets. It's supported for any Power BI content the app user can view. And in licensing, ASCUs are not supported. Note that we'll be covering licensing in a later video in this series. So now let's see how the authentication flow works.
So your app users will authenticate with Azure AD to acquire their access token in an interactive authentication flow. Once the Azure AD token is acquired, the app will cache this access token and it will use it to embed any Power BI content that the app user has permission to view.
Noam, what's a good example of using the For Your Organization scenario?
So a good example of For Your Organization is embedding for Teams and SharePoint, but not only. You should consider using the For Your Organization scenario when you want a custom experience instead of the Power BI service experience. You should also consider it if you're looking to integrate Power BI content with other content, or if your data access permissions need to be those of the app user. Lastly, you should consider using the For Your Organization scenario if you're looking for customized audit logging of your content.
Okay, let's now describe important facts when developing for the For Your Customer scenario. When using your app, the app user does not require a Power BI account or license. Any authentication method can be used by the app. A dedicated Azure AD identity is used to authenticate with Power BI, and it can be either the service principal or master user account. An embed token is required to embed Power BI content when using an effective identity. And it requires specific licensing, A or P SKUs. Again, we'll be covering licensing in a later video of this series. Let's now talk a bit more about the embed token.
The embed token represents several facts. It represents which Power BI content can be accessed, and also the access level, so whether it can only be viewed or also edited for reports. Optionally, effective identities can be used to access content and also query the data. And the embed token can also represent the target workspace for save as of reports. Keep in mind that the embed token will expire when the access token expires. However, your app can be developed to silently regenerate the embed token once it expires.
Great. Now let's see how the authentication flow works in this scenario.
In this scenario, your app user authenticates to the app with any authentication method. The app uses a dedicated Azure AD identity to acquire an access token for the user. This is done through a non-interactive authentication flow. Once the access token is acquired, the app will cache it and use it to generate an embed token, which is required to embed Power BI content.
Remember, in this course, we focus mainly on this scenario. Next, let's talk about the two types of embedding identities. They are Service Principal and Master User.
An Azure Service Principal is a security identity used by apps. It can authenticate using an app secret or a certificate. And when used to access Power BI content, the app will use the Service Principal to acquire an access token. The Service Principal must be an admin or member of the workspace that contains the content to be embedded. Keep in mind that the Service Principal does not need a Power BI Pro license. And lastly, a Power BI tenant admin must first enable the use of Service Principals and register Service Principal security groups.
And let's see how that's done. So here in the admin portal, under tenant settings and under the developer settings group, a Power BI admin can enable the Service Principal and also specify the security groups that can work with the Service Principal. Okay, let's now talk about the second identity type, the Master User account.
The Master User is a regular Azure AD user. When used to access Power BI content, the app will use the user account to acquire an access token. The Master User must belong to the admin or member roles of the workspace that contains the content to be embedded. In this case, the Master User must have either a Power BI Pro or Power BI Premium per user license.
All right, that's a lot of information to take in, so let's now review what we've introduced by comparing the capabilities of both identity types.
So for the Service Principal, the Azure AD object type will be a Service Principal. The credentials will be managed in a secret or certificate rotation management. The Power BI tenant settings must be enabled, and a Service Principal must belong to a declared security group. As for the API usage, you can use all of the APIs except for some admin operations and some data flows operations. It's not possible to sign into the Power BI service with a Service Principal, and a Power BI Pro license is not required. This is the Azure AD recommendation.
Now for the Master User, it's just an Azure AD user, and from a credential management point of view, it's up to you to apply frequent password changes. There are no Power BI tenant settings, and the Master User has access to all API operations. It is possible to sign in using the Master User to the Power BI service, and note that a Power BI Pro license will be required. However, this is not an Azure AD recommendation. So which identity should you use? We've prepared some guidance to help you.
Generally, the Service Principal is a good choice for production. The Service Principal is the recommended approach by Azure AD. It supports better automation and scale, and there is less management overhead. However, it does require Azure AD and Power BI admin rights to set up and manage.
The Master User is a good choice for development or test environments. It's easy to set up. It can be used to sign into the Power BI service to help troubleshoot issues. However, it requires a Power BI Pro license. In the next video, I'll demonstrate how to configure permissions.